Hello, I'm Kedar Khanulkar from Vector. In this video, we'll be talking about how to connect my Vector network interface via Ethernet cable to my computer. This Ethernet host mode can be used as an alternative to an USB connection to your computer, and it can be done via Vector Hardware Manager. This will allow you to extend the distance up to 100 meters and have a scalable amount of Vector interface connections to a single computer. Also, it will enable the PTP-1588 synchronization as well. Also, on supported devices, 10 gigabit uplink is possible. However, please note that Ethernet host mode is supported when the VN interface is powered via a delivered power supply, and the VN interface will not work as a license carrier if it is configured as host mode. Now, we'll move on the demonstration part. To start with the demonstration, I have opened Vector Hardware Manager and I have connected the device VN5620 for demonstration. The list of other devices which support this is provided in the Knowledge Base article. I have connected it via USB and powered on with the delivered power supply. Now I will switch to Configuration View. I will select the Windows Properties Configuration, and I will click on this drop-down, and I will click on Ethernet Host. By default, the VN interface host IP address is 192.168.0.1, and the subnet is 255.255.255.0, which cannot be changed. Please note that IPv6 is not supported. Now you can choose the IP address as per your needs. Now here, for example, I will make it to 4 and I will deploy it. You can see there is a deployment success. We'll click on OK. Now the next step is to configure your computer's Ethernet interface accordingly. For that, I will go to Windows Search and type the shortcut ncap.cpl. This will take me to the network connections, and you can see this is the USB to Ethernet adapter. I will right click and I will click on properties. Please note that you need full admin rights to do this. Now I will go to IPv4. I will click on properties. I will use the following IP address and I will enter 192.168.0. Just for example, I will take 5. And now I will enter the subnet mask and I will click on OK. And I can now close this. So once this is done, I will unplug the VN interface from the power supply. And I will also disconnect the USB connection as well. I will now remove it from the configuration. Now I will power up the VN interface. Once this is done, I will connect the VN interface host port to the computer via an Ethernet patch cable. Once this is done, I will open the burger menu by clicking on the three horizontal lines, and I will go to network devices. And you can see that we have 5620, which is available to be connected. Now I will click on connect, and the status is connected. Can go back and add this configuration. And if I switch to the status view, I can see there is Ethernet uplink. However, an easier and more straightforward approach, independent of firewall IP address config, Windows TCP IP config, would be to use our new interface VN 5601. Please find the link below on how to configure VN5601. To end with, I have two additional points. For the legacy devices 5610 and 5640, the Ethernet host mode is only available when the VN interface is configured with network-based access. The devices which do not feature the DUSB port like 5240 and VN5430, the default IP address is 192.168.0.1. If you want to change this IP address, first you need to connect the VN interface using the mentioned default IP address. Afterwards, you can change it as per your requirement. Thank you.